Cerebro. Yeah, Cerebro is a man who come out for you. Big up Cerebro. More likely you're getting a little flash in the vlog there, my brother.
Being on camera is
weird.
I feel like the whole world
watching
me.
I get about 100 views a week, so no problem. Hardcore Henry, this is the whole movie?
Yeah, on Netflix.
I'm in
Where'd you finish it?
I'm in his office.
Just had a good chat with my buddy Urshad there. Real, really determined, talented young guy.
Yo.
He's kind of like I. Just the music, and with all the nerd shit,
we in a gear.
So here we are. A week has gone by and not much has happened, as expected. Life really isn't a movie, even though I do try really hard to make my vlog as cinematic as possible. If you followed along with my story, you'd know that last week was a tough one, because I was sick. So this week, I had a lot to catch up on. I have to take care of myself. That's the sentiment that echoed in my head. In this business, if you're down, everything else follows. So this vlog I'll have to keep short. By the way, how this vlog works is that I record the highlights of my week, which starts on a Sunday and ends Saturday. Then, I edit over the next week while remembering to record that week's highlights. It's a lot of work considering the style, but this is exactly what I signed up for. And I really appreciate the viewership, likes, shares, and feedback I've gotten so far. My goal is to remain as consistent as I can, while balancing everything else. And this week, there were only a few days that were eventful. So, for the sake of the most impactful discussion I had on Thursday, let's talk about the thin line between moving forward and giving up. My martial arts is something I kept very personal. It was nothing I thought to show off or brag about. It's one of the things that keeps me grounded, and the reason I do it goes way beyond kicks and punches. I can't always train like I want, but I do make the time. Needless to say, the camaraderie I feel here is unrivaled. I learn, I teach, and I learn again. I am forever grateful for all the lessons I've learned through martial arts. Wednesday, I continued working with my bro Kevon Carter.
So long, let's see what's in this shot. Screen?
Yes, yeah. Trying to keep that vibes alive now.
Yeah.
You gotta edit this, right?
Yeah, of course we have. Definitely. Right?
That's all we're giving them
for. That's all we're
giving them
for.
It's Thursday. Stick with me here. We're getting to the point, I promise.
Yeah.
Saga!
I had a video shoot with Silva and Mark Hardy and I. I've come to realize that I'm the only person in a shirt. I still wear any all black dress code, but I'm the only guy in a shirt.
He's like the lawyer in the group.
What? Black lawyer. There we go.
He's the political general.
He's the lawyer in the video. This is the guys behind the camera today. It doesn't always be me.
Boy Nesh, Crown Life, Forever Focus Media.
Definitely.
Rapper.
These guys are gonna get it. They definitely had the weapons to seriously shoot that A7 S Mark II.
Probably like 15 years. I love it. I can't picture myself really doing anything else. I have passions for the things like business and marketing and fashion and stuff, but music is keep my life.
I remember one of your I don't know if this was your first song or your first video, but shot in Shagarama Spear 2.
Yeah,
one of the lyrics in his song, yeah, one of the lyrics in his song was, if this music thing don't work out, I got my law degree.
Yeah.
But after
yeah,
15 years, why ain't fall back on that law degree, man?
I mean, I don't mean to sound bad or people don't take this the wrong way, but I feel like if I became an attorney, I would just be another lawyer. I feel like with what myself and Rods did with Trap So, and, you know, like, even stuff I done with Bad Royal and stuff I did as a solo artist in the past, I feel like I have some kind of purpose now. I feel like in my own little way, even if it's what 0.0001% of history, I'm making history in my own way now. And I feel like that means something to me. Even if I do make it as an artist, if I open doors for the artist in the future, I think that is my purpose.
You see, we're back at the word purpose. It will probably remain a mystery for a long time for all of us, why something we want to do so quickly turns into something we have to do. When they speak, it sounds like destiny. A thing not necessary to survive seems to be keeping these people alive. Is it fair to then refer to this as mere entertainment or a pipe dream? Their words go way beyond just talk.
How long are you doing this music thing, man?
Why too long? What should I do? It's too long. I can't even give you an estimate.
Why didn't stop yet? What do you think?
You can't stop, man. When God bless you with that talent, stopping is like a distant garden. What should I? You can't do that, though.
What's driving me is basically the fact that, like, I don't see myself doing anything else now. Like, it's just like, this is it now. Like, you know when you're like in life, you reach like your crossroads. It's like, you know, this is it. That's me and the music, right? Like, this is it.
You know, in a career that cultivates doubt, it's nothing short of a miracle that people see themselves as bound to a dream. Is it drive or delusions, I ask? It's not just music, it's not just anything creative, it's anything you feel that is truly yours. What if fate had it that our dreams weren't for us? Would we draw the line and stop? Can our craft truly inspire change, or will we have to accept reality? Everyone I've met along the way seems to have a different path on the same road. Some even gave up to seek success in a different direction. Can our dreams destroy us? Are we fighting against reality? Or is it that our dream is truly worth fighting for? The scary part is, you'll only truly know at the end of the line.